Hello, my name is Niamh. I'm from Breakthrough Maths. Welcome to a step-by-step instructional video on how to prove that cos squared theta plus sine squared theta is equal to 1. Okay, so this proof is going to come in two parts. We've got a small construction and then we've got a small mathematical proof, and I'm going to work through both now. Before we do either of those, I want to draw your attention just to this right angle triangle here below. Now, if I just mark in as theta, we know some angle theta being here. And I'm also going to give you the fact that the hypotenuse of this triangle is the length 1. Okay, hypotenuse being the side opposite the right angle in this triangle. Now, what's interesting about this is that if you know the angle theta, and if we know that the hypotenuse is 1, then we can automatically find out what the opposite side is and the adjacent side. I'm going to show you that now. So the opposite side is the side opposite the angle theta, marked it in as O, and the adjacent side is just the other side remaining. Now, sine theta, we know, is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. But the hypotenuse here is equal to 1. So this is automatically equal to O over 1. Anything over 1 is just itself. Okay, O over 1 is just O, 2 over 1 is 2, 16 over 1 is 16. Okay, so that we have straight away that the opposite side, O, is equal to sine theta. Similarly, we have cos theta is equal to A over H, adjacent over hypotenuse. The hypotenuse here we already know is 1 again. So we have A over 1, and that's just equal to A. So the adjacent side is equal to cos theta. So when as triangles constructed in this way, where the hypotenuse is equal to 1, then we can write the opposite side purely in terms of sine theta and the adjacent side as cos theta. Okay, now we're ready for our construction. So we're going to construct a unit circle, okay? That's just any circle with a radius of 1. And through the center of that circle, we're going to put an x-axis and a y-axis, okay? So the center of the circle is going to be the origin, the point 0, 0, and we're going to make an x and y-axis through a unit circle. Now, even though the radius has to be 1, it could be 1 centimeter or 1 meter or one something that you completely make up. So we don't have to measure the radius, which is nice. We can draw a circle of any size. So you can pick the size yourself, whatever suits you. So using our compass, guys, I'm just going to trace out a circle. And I know it's not that strong because I'm using pencil, but once I finish this part, the rest will be in pen, okay? Okay, so it's a unit circle. So the first thing I want you to do, okay, is I want you to take your pencil and I want you to mark out very, very clearly the center of the circle. So the part that the compass punctured a hole in the paper, I want you to do a big, big mark around that. So mine one was about here. Here's the center of my circle. Okay, now through that center, you are going to draw your x-axis and your y-axis. So through the center of my circle, I'm going to draw a vertical line directly through it. And this is going to be my y-axis. And I'm going to do a dotted line here, guys. I'm doing it in pen. You're going to do it in pencil. And you're doing a horizontal line directly across. This is going to be your x-axis. Beautiful. Now, I pick a point on the circumference of the circle, like in the first quadrant here somewhere. I'm just going to pick it about here. I'm going to label this as the point P, and I'm going to label my center as the point O. Okay? Now, joining those two points, this is my radius. And it's a unit circle, guys, so we said the radius is going to be 1. So I'm going to join these two nicely. And straight away, I can mark in this distance as 1, because we're at a unit circle. Now, this is the origin, so it's the point 0, 0. So again, I could mark that in. 0, 0. The point P, some people might have already guessed it, I'm going to mark it in as the point cos theta sine theta. Okay, I'm going to show you where this is now, guys. So this line here, we can form a right angle triangle, okay, in our circle. So we just draw a line straight down here, straight across here. And let's say that this is the angle theta. Then what is the length of the side of this triangle going to be on this side? As we said before, it's going to be sine theta. And the length of this triangle on the other side, we said before, is going to be cos theta. Therefore, this is the point cos theta on the x-axis, cos theta. On the y, it goes up the length sine theta. So this is the point cos theta, sine theta. So this is why we did that little bit of prep before we started our construction. Now the last thing we need to do is we just need to mark in the point 0, 0. We can call it x1, y1. And the point P, I'm going to call these x2, y2. And that's going to become clear now as we do the mathematical part of the proof. Okay, let's now get on with the mathematical part of the proof. So we know that the distance between O and P is equal to 1. So we're basically going to find the distance of between O and P, the points 0, 0, and the point cos theta sine theta, using our distance formula, and then let it equal to 1 to get our result. So OP, the distance OP, we know is equal to 1. We also know the distance between any two points on a plane is given by the distance formula. This is in your log tables under coordinate geometry. By the square root of x2 minus x1 all squared plus y2 minus y1 all squared. Now, really nicely, we've already labeled these things in our construction. So it's just a matter of subbing in 0, 0 as x1, y1. Cos theta sine theta is x2, y2 into our distance formula. So let's do that. So we have that the distance OP is equal to the square root all of x2, which is cos theta, minus x1, which is 0, all squared, plus y2, which is sine theta, minus y1, which is 0, all squared. Now cos theta minus 0 is just cos theta, sine theta minus 0, just sine theta. So we can simplify this. So this is equal to cos squared theta plus sine squared theta. Now OP we already know is equal to 1, so let's just straight away let that equal to 1. Now we want to get rid of our square root here, and what do we always do to get rid of a square root, guys? We square both sides. So squaring the left hand side, squaring the right hand side, our square cancels with our square root. 1 squared is equal to 1 times 1 is equal to 1. So 1 is equal to the square root of, 1 is equal to, our square root is already cancelled, cos squared theta plus sine squared theta. And we're done.